Oh, you can see where my nipples are.
Oh, look at that!
Right? I mean, that's what I'm assuming. Otherwise, they're like huge moles that I didn't have before.
You're gonna miss your drains, huh?
Oh my god, no. I need these to be off my body.
Ash had a very, very rough morning.
I vomited like a dozen times.
Yeah.
Because I had a migraine. In my theories, I had the migraine because the bandages are causing me so much like tightness and muscle pain and stuff. I could be wrong. I'm just an Ash, not a doctor.
Yeah, they have a huge thunderstorm going on, which is good luck for us.
Is it?
For me? Therefore, it's for you. I'm passing it along.
You'll share your thunderstorm luck.
Yep. All right.
Sit forward with your feet on the ground. Just pass your shirt off there. That's going to hit the ground. I would probably recommend turning your hat around because once you lay back, it's going to flip and hit the ground.
Sounds good.
Seen this a few times. So, yeah. Now, everything I talked to you about today is written down in the post-op instruction sheets that I gave you last week. Okay. So if you forget anything, which most people do, it's all there.
Yeah, I bet most people are more excited than they are paying attention.
Yeah, I think it's kind of a whirlwind of emotions. And uh-huh. They don't remember. There's a lot of stuff, too. And just stay right there, but put your elbows on the sides. Okay, so hold that for me. And hold that for me. And I'm going to leave this off for a few hours, okay?
Okay.
I want you to put this back on later today. It does not need to be tight, just a little bit snug.
Okay.
You need to wear this every day for the next 2 weeks, taking it off only to shower.
Okay.
And then you'll need to wash it too. So when you wash it, you're going to unravel it, you're going to put it inside of a pillowcase, and then wash and dry it in the pillowcase so it doesn't get damaged.
Sounds good. But wear it constantly besides the next few, okay.
Just snug, not like.
Yeah.
Yeah, just like a sock.
Okay. Okay?
It's going to serve a couple of purposes. It's going to help remind you, number one, you've had surgery, because some people don't remember,
you know? They just go.
They do crazy stuff. And then it adds a little bit of compression. Awesome. Okay. I'm going to put this over here on top of this plastic bag.
Okay.
You put it inside that bag before you leave the room.
I love you. You've got this. Oh my goodness.
There you go. All right, why don't you stand up and take a look. Looks awesome.
Yeah, that's so good. Oh, that's so good. Oh, cool. Oh, that's so good. I was so worried. Oh, neat. Oh, cool.
Oh, honey, you're awesome.
Thank you. Yay, thank you so much.
You're welcome. So let me explain to you what's going on here. Okay, so basically, you've got some typical ripples and wrinkles, puffiness. That's all going to go away over the next several weeks, okay?
Mm-hmm.
The tape strips, you're going to leave these on for another week. If they don't fall off by next week, you can peel them off, and you're okay to use scar guard on the incisions.
Okay.
The nipples are in the lower outer border of the pectoralis muscle on both sides.
Uh-huh.
If you lift your arms up to the side, it's nice and flat. There's no puckering or anything like that, but it's all looks great.
Awesome.
Okay?
It does look really, really, really good.
All right. Let's get your grains out, okay?
Awesome.
So we're going to scoot all the way back, just like that.
Sounds good.
How does it feel having the bandage on?
Really amazing. The bandage was rough.
Yeah, everybody says it's brutal, but it's necessary.
Yeah, no, that makes sense. I mean, better for the long game. That way you're not so puffy or swollen.
You look great, babe.
That's so cool.
Do you mind if I get a better...
The best spot's like right there is good, or in the corner, but I'm going to run back and forth.
Yep.
With like a scissor and I don't want to stab you.
Well, I appreciate that. That's very kind.
Just like a body slide behind. Just like that. Good. Now let's bring your arms out to the sides. Okay, so just like that. Perfect. Just position this so I can take these out. Okay. So I'm going to cut the suture holding the drain in place. You're going to feel a little pinch. Just like that.
Mm-hmm.
we're going to take out your drain. So what I want you to do is you're going to turn your head that way, and you're going to take a deep breath in and blow out and take out the drain. So deep breath, and go ahead and blow out, and it's already out.
Oh, nice. Cool.
Let's do this side.
Oops, sorry.
Turn your head that way. Same thing, deep breath, and blow out. That's it, no more drains.
Awesome.
Now there's a tiny hole right at the end of the incision. You need to cover that with a bandage.
Okay.
It's an antibiotic ointment once a day. It takes about a week to close up, and it may leak some fluids. Don't be alarmed.
Okay. How much should I limit my range of motion? Am I...
Just a this. That's
okay.
It. Okay?
As I say, this feels pretty like wide for me.
Well, that's because I'm taking the
right.
bandages off right now.
Okay, cool.
Those same restrictions that you have after surgery are going to go on for the next 2 weeks. I really want you to take it easy.
Gotcha.
Now, the nipples always look a little gross initially. The outer layer of skin peels away over the next week. The new skin cells, I'll show you in a second. Just put my mics back. Don't worry. I'm going to show you. If you're looking around, feel kind of move. I don't want to cut
the
whole thing. The new skin cells grow on top of it over the next couple of weeks.
Okay.
And then the nipple projection returns usually after about several weeks. I'll show you in just a second. It looks really good.
Oh, cool.
Do you want this still filmed, though?
I think you're kind of good.